Before Ming Dynasty, the Empress biological mother and the Empress of late Emperor couldn't become the Empress Dowager at the same time. Usually, the Empress automatically became the Empress Dowager. The Empress biological mother was promoted to the consort dowager. Having two Empress Dowagers at the same time only happened in Ming and Qing dynasties. So, in whole ancient Chinese history, there were only six pairs of Empress Dowagers. The first pair was the Empress Dowager Sun and the Empress Dowager Wu. The Empress Dowager Sun was the Empress of Xuanzong. When Xuanzong passed away, their son became the emperor, so the Empress Sun became the Empress Dowager. In 1449, Yingzhong was captured by Mongolian leader in Tumu Crisis. Yingzhong's half-brother became the Emperor Jing Tai. Jing Tai was born by Xuanzong's consort Xian. Because Jing Tai got the throne in an unusual situation, so he broke the rules and promoted his biological mother to the Empress Dowager. In 1457, Jing Tai passed away. Yingzhong restored his throne. He dethroned Jing Tai from the emperor to the prince and demoted the Empress Dowager Wu to the consort Xian. So, the consort Xian wasn't considered as the Empress Dowager by future Ming Empress. In official historical documents, she was recorded as the consort Xian, not the Empress. The second pair was the Empress Dowager Qian and the Empress Dowager Zhou. The Empress Dowager Qian was Yingzhong's Empress. Because the Empress Xian didn't give birth any kids, when Yingzhong passed away, Yingzhong and his noble consort Zhou's son inherited the throne. When Yingzhong was alive, the noble consort Zhou already had conflicts with the Empress Qian. But because Yingzhong stood on the Empress Qian's side, the noble consort Zhou couldn't beat the Empress. But after Yingzhong passed away, everything was changed. The Empress Dowager Zhou got the support from her biological son and got better living conditions than real Empress Dowager Qian. 4 years after Yingzhong passed away, the Empress Dowager Qian died. Then the Empress Dowager Zhou became the real highest status woman in the country. The third pair was the Empress Dowager Chen and the Empress Dowager Li. The Empress Dowager Chen was the Empress of the Emperor Muzong. Because she didn't give birth a boy, the throne was passed to the son of Muzong and the imperial noble consort Li. The imperial noble consort Li originally was Empress Chen's maid. They married Muzong before he became the emperor. The Empress Chen was really pretty, but didn't be liked by her husband. Well, the imperial noble consort Li gave birth two boys and three girls for Muzong, and her oldest son was promoted to the crown prince. She was the one of Muzong's favorite consorts. Different with Yingzhong's empress Xiao Su, the imperial noble consort Li really respected the empress. So the Empress Chen and the imperial noble consort Li had a great relationship. When Mu Zong passed away, the Emperor Wan Li was only 9 years old. The court was managed by two empress dowagers. They chose Zhang Jucheng as the chief officer, and the Ming dynasty got his last prosperity. The fourth pair was the Empress Xiao Duanwen and the Empress Xiao Zhuangwen. Xiao Zhuang was the niece of Xiao Duan. They were princes of Keqin Mongol Borji Jite clan. In 1614, in the political marriage between Keqin and Ai Xin Jieluo, 14-year-old Princess Zheze was married with 22-year-old Huang Taiji. 11 years after marriage, Xiao Duan first time gave birth a child, who was Huang Taiji's second daughter. In the same year, 12-year-old Xiao Zhuang married Huang Taiji as secondary consort. In the following 11 years, Xiao Duan gave birth one girl and Xiao Zhuang gave birth two girls. So, in 1634, the third Borji Jite princess, Hai Lanzhu, was married with Huang Taiji. Hai Lanzhu was Huang Taiji's true love. She gave birth Huang Taiji's eighth son, who was considered as the crown prince by Huang Taiji. Unfortunately, this little prince only lived 7 months. 2 days after eighth prince passed away, Xiao Zhuang gave birth Huang Taiji's ninth son, Fu Lin. In 1643, Huang Taiji passed away. 5 years old Fu Lin inherited the throne. Xiao Duan and Xiao Zhuang became the empress dowagers. The court was managed by the Prince Rui of the first rank. In 1644, Qing replaced Ming. Two empress dowagers moved to the Forbidden City. 5 years later, Xiao Duanwen passed away. Xiao Zhuang died in Kangxi's time. She helped two generations of Qing empress and was considered as the greatest empress dowager in Qing dynasty. The fifth pair was the Empress Xiao Huizhang and the Empress Xiao Kangzhang. Xiao Huizhang was princess of Keqin Mongol Borji Jite clan and the second empress of Shunzhi. Xiao Kangzhang was Shunzhi's consort. When Shunzhi was alive, his true love was the imperial noble consort Dong E. Xiao Hui and Xiao Kang's great day started when Shunzhi passed away. Xiao Kang's son inherited the throne, who was known as the Emperor Kangxi. Unfortunately, Xiao Kang only lived as the Empress Dowager for 2 years. Xiao Hui passed away at 77, 4 years before Kangxi passed away. Xiao Hui and Kangxi had a great relationship, so she had a happy retirement life. The last pair was the Empress Xiao Zhenxian and the Empress Xiao Qinxian. They had a more famous names, the Empress Dowager Ci An and the Empress Dowager Cixi. Cixi was Xianfeng's empress. Cixi was Xianfeng's noble consort. After Xianfeng passed away, they ranged behind the curtain in Tongzhi and Guangxu's time. When Cixi was alive, the final decision must be made by her. So, Cixi didn't have absolute powers. In 1881, Cian suddenly passed away. Then, Cixi became the only ruler of Qing until she passed away. Thank you for watching this video. See you soon.